Broadly, energy poverty is defined as the inability to adequately cool or heat your home. Now, this can occur for many reasons. You may experience really high energy bills. You may have inefficiencies in your home, like lack of insulation or a really inefficient appliance. Or for some reason, you may just be unwilling to spend money on your cooling or heating systems. So one of the things that we have been looking at is who is unable to use their air conditioning system, particularly as we are moving throughout the summer season. This is going to be really important because a recent study by Iverson et al. Published in 2020 showed that 347 heat-related deaths occurred indoors despite all of those households having an air conditioning unit. Now, in roughly 228 of those households, the air conditioners were all deemed to be working. But for some reason, these households felt like they either couldn't use it or couldn't afford to use it. And we need scalable methods to find these homes because the major plan as we are looking at climate mitigation plans of cities is deploying air conditioning units. That's our plan locally and our plan globally. But there are going to be households that feel like they can't afford to use their air conditioners, and we need to find these households and then make sure that plans are in place to aid them when trying to consume more energy. This is one thing that our recent study has focused on, where we use smart meter data to identify who is currently not using as much air conditioning as we would expect them to. Smart meter data is data that the electric company receives from your household that says this is how many units of electricity or kilowatt hours that the household is using throughout the day. And what we do is we connect that to temperature and weather data. Then I can say, okay, well, these are your households that are currently not using their air conditioning units when we would expect them to. And that allows for better targeting of energy efficiency deployments as well as energy assistance. One of the key findings in our study is that on average, low-income groups are using 1.04 kilowatt hours per degree Fahrenheit less than their high-income counterparts. Now, this is concerning to us because a small window unit would use even less energy than that. And that is meaning that either these households don't have window units, they're not using them, or for some reason, they are foregoing this energy consumption throughout the summer season. That's going to impact their health, their productivity, their ability to work from home. And that's something that we need to consider as we are planning our energy systems in the future. Another challenge in the energy space is that utilities are very risk averse, which is understandable because people are very upset when the energy is not there when they need it. It literally grinds us to a halt. And that makes it harder to implement new technologies into the electric and gas utility system space. Now, that's one thing that I like about Carnegie Mellon is that we have the opportunity to work with our technology transfer office, and we actually have started a company, People's Energy Analytics, to help move this work from the research space into the operation space. By working with People's Energy Analytics, that has provided another avenue to make sure that the research doesn't just stay in papers, but actually gets to be used by the people that need it.